Well, hi there. My name's Josh Pitka, and I'm the lead pastor of Dunamis Church, Sarnia, here in Sarnia, Ontario. And if you're watching this, you probably know that, but you may not. And doing my morning devotions today, I was up at 5 o'clock and just got to spend some time with the Lord. And He really stirred my heart to begin to do a daily video blog again. And just to share a word from the Lord, to share an impartation, to share an encouragement, something from the Holy Spirit to you. I've been walking with God now for over 15 years, and not just casually either. I have attempted to follow Him with all of my heart, with all of my life. And in that, we've seen hundreds of people saved, if you count trips overseas and stuff like that, thousands of people potentially receiving Christ, thousands of people physically healed on the streets, and just seen many mighty miracles, and smaller miracles, and mid-sized miracles, and just seeing God move, seeing the power of the Holy Spirit. And I really want to share with you, if you're a believer, or even if you aren't, just on a daily basis, or on a regular basis at least, sometimes it's hard to get to it every day, but just to share an encouragement, share a word from the Lord, from my spirit to yours, and I pray that you'd be encouraged. So I want to pray right now and just share a quick word with you. Well, Father, I pray for every person that is listening to this right now, and it may be tomorrow, or 5 years, or 10 years, or 20 years down the road, but I pray right now that the person listening to this would be encouraged, would be lifted up, and would be equipped for what you have for them in Jesus' name. Amen. Today is August 11th, 2014, and I want to share a word just very quickly about surrender. In the Christian life, Christianity truly begins when one takes on the disposition that they completely surrender to Jesus. Romans 12, verse 1. The Apostle Paul says, "I appeal to you therefore, brothers, by the mercies of God," reading out of the English Standard Version, the ESV. I appeal to you, brothers, by the mercies of God. Now that word brothers means brothers and sisters. It's in the Greek, wasn't just referring to men, it was referring to all people. So brothers and sisters, I refer to you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. So spiritual worship is not singing songs at church on Sunday or at youth group or at Sunday night. Or spiritual worship isn't singing. Spiritual worship is surrender. To truly worship God, we need to give Him the entirety of our lives, our bodies, to present to Him the essence of who you are, and say, "Father, I am yours." And as you walk that out, that is worship that is acceptable to God. And so I want to encourage you out of Romans 12:1 today to truly begin your journey with God and surrender to Him everything. Now the thing that happens that when you begin to do that is the battle of faith begins to happen in your life. And you know, even the devil takes notice. You know, the devil doesn't really bother you know, just people that go to church. In fact, he hangs out at some churches. But the devil bothers, he harasses, he tries to stop people that have really given their lives to the Holy Spirit. Because when you've given your life to God, when you've surrendered to the Spirit of God, when you've surrendered and made Jesus the Lord of your life, life begins to flow through you. Darkness begins to dispel because His presence, when you give your life to Him, you start to connect with His presence. And His presence is life. His presence is life. His presence is light. And when light begins to shine in you, Jesus said to the disciples, He said, "You are the light of the world. Therefore, do not hide your light under a basket. Do not hide it, you know, but let it shine. Be on it. Be like a light on a hill, and let all men see your good works, that they may glorify your Father in heaven." And so when you begin to surrender to God, a natural course begins to happen. And God begins to move through you. You begin to, as you fall in love with Him and spend time with Him, something begins to shift. And so I want to make you aware of that. Surrendering to God is not a light thing. It's not a casual thing. It's a focused thing. It's an intentional thing. And it's a surrender to Him. It's a willful act of choice on your behalf to give Him your life. I encourage you to give Him your life. Pray with me right now. If this message is if this word, if this encouragement is just touching your heart, just pray and say, Father, today is a new day. The past is behind me. Today I give you my life. Father, give me your wisdom. Father, fill me with your grace. Incline my heart to you. I give you my life in Jesus' name. I surrender all to Jesus. Amen. I hope you've been blessed today, and I really pray that there would be an authentic surrender in your life, and hopefully we'll see you tomorrow, God willing.